Hey guys, it's me, Mr. Lionfish, and I'm making my first tutorial. And today we're gonna do a tutorial on how to make kick drums. And I'm gonna show you how I do that. And for the low end, I use this plugin called Kick 2. Very nice plugin, and this is what it looks like. We're basically making a kick from a sine wave. And we're gonna be making a dubstep kick, but all the stuff that you'll learn in this, you can apply to whatever genre you make. And the first thing I do is I set this length here. So for dubstep, it's around like 420, 428, right on the dot. So yeah, and then after that, I mute this click, because I don't do the clicky parts in Kick 2. Sometimes I will either use the subby part and make the click with that, or I'll do a simple, and we'll kind of go through and I'll decide. Or I'll do one of both. But yeah, your kick should sound like this. Next thing I do is I just set my amp envelope to get it like that, like. You can make your kick long like that, or short. I like mine short, so like. Bit more fadey. And then I set the pitch. I don't really do too much. Turn that EQ off for now and the distortion. Just till I find something that sounds good. Go ahead and this song. Sometimes I use the compression in here. Not always. I don't think I'm gonna do it with this one. And then go ahead, make a MIDI note like so. And then I always freeze it, flatten it to audio. And then for this one, I'm gonna use another kick for the transient part. So we'll just pick a kick. That sounds good when this thing decides to work. Okay, there we, oh, hold on. Okay. Yeah, we'll pick that one. And then what I do, I'll solo and I'll listen to it. And then I'll do about zoom in. I don't think it can zoom in any further. About there. do on here. I'll just fade it. So this is going to be the tail, and that's going to be the transient. Essentially what we're doing. Then I'll put a... No, I don't want to do that. Put a spectrum on there. I'm going to look at this first. There we go. So that's a B. I'm going to look at this. There we go. And that's a D. So... let's tune this down. 3. Turn warp on first. So yeah, there's the basic kick, and then what I like to do is I like to group them, and I will go through, and I'll just put effects on there. When I'm making them, I don't EQ any of the drums when I make drums. I save that for when I put it in the track. It's like, yeah, I know it's got a lot of sub now, but maybe for one track I might want that extra sub, or with like a different track I may not, so it's better I don't mess with EQ or any of that stuff. I throw drum bus on there sometimes. That's nice and punchy. Turn that, we'll turn the decay down a little bit on that. I'm just gonna bring up the transient. Then glue compressor setting, that's just the bass punch. Just tames it back. And then waves C6, sometimes, not always. And I just flip through. Usually, and then I'll put it right for that. But yeah, I don't do EQ when I make drums, just because I'll do it when I put it in the track, and there's no sense in EQing it, and then, like, well, I have the kick sounding mixed, but then I put it in a track, and then it doesn't sound fit for the track. Like, you'd be like, oh, well, this kick fit, I like it. It's just that with the, yeah, so. And then. And then I'll show you how to make one that's entirely with kick 2, where I'm using that subby part as the click. So, go back. Here will be. Get as close. Get that. Put it there. freeze it. Flatten it. Oh, yeah, I guess all of that. Just combine that. And then again. Ooh, that actually sounds nice. Don't want that much. But yeah, it's a lot of like trial and error, and you want to make sure that your transient is in the same key. Well, but it fits with, because like with this one there, that's at D and that's at B. That's only like a 3-note difference, but it actually sounds fine to me. I might not exactly. And then actually something that I will do sometimes with kicks, so we'll group that one. Insert another MIDI track, another note, same length. And then we'll add white noise. We'll just use Saron. Not everybody has Saron, but any plugin that has white noise. White noise. And it's accentuating that transient a little bit, and it's adding more high-endness to it, because like just this sounds good, but it's adding like a nice punch to it, like we'll make that an audio as well. See if you were to hear that but then what I'll do on this is I'll sometimes cut it out, because white noise fills up the whole spectrum, and you don't want the bass part of it, because you're not using the white noise for that. So yeah, now you don't have to add the white noise, you can literally just see the like. I'll just render these out to audio in case I want to fade it like. I'll go ahead. And then you can leave it. So, yeah, that's how I make kicks with kick two layering samples and white noise. Hope you enjoyed.